Welcome to the Pikto Gallery. We're here today to show you our current exhibition, Yousuf Karsh, one of the masters of 20th century photography. We're happy to present today this Pikto Nexi presentation of Yousuf's work for everybody who couldn't make it down to the National Gallery itself to view the images. The images comprise of portraits, mostly Hollywood stars from the era of the 40s, 60s, even the 50s as well. Such people as Audrey Hepburn, legendary photograph of Audrey Hepburn that we have to my right, Charlton Heston. We also have other images such as Brigitte Bardot we have behind me here. But we will show you these in our presentation. We'd love to share it on the Pikto Nexi community, share our photography exhibition with you. So please enjoy. Karsh is widely known as one of the greatest portrait photographers to have lived. He was born in 1908 and arrived in Halifax in Canada in 1925 from Beirut. He's quickly made Ottawa his home after spending a small amount of time in the States studying photography and set up a portrait studio there, photographing statesmen, musicians, actors, scientists, all sorts of interesting people that he became very close friends with. He became friends with these people and actually became almost a high society artist himself, even schmoozing with the Queen of England. So please enjoy the exhibition. If you feel like asking us questions, of course, email us at info@pikto.com. We will always return your emails and try and answer your question. And I hope you enjoy it. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.
Yousuf Karsh is regarded as one of the masters of 20th century photography. Pikto is proud to present a selection of his legendary portraits. These portraits were exhibited at the Pikto Gallery, the Distillery District, Toronto, during the Toronto Film Festival in September 2009. The private collection of images was kindly lent to us by Shelton Chen. After spending time in the States, Karsh moved back to Canada and settled in Ottawa. Interested in photographing the world leaders, Karsh opens up a photography studio and begins capturing, after much trial and error, the many statesmen, actors, artists, scientists, musicians, and of course royalty, creating images that undoubtedly secured Karsh as one of the greatest portrait photographers of his time and all time. Yousuf Karsh's dramatic glimpses of public figures such as Humphrey Bogart, Brigitte Bardot, Audrey Hepburn, Charlton Heston, Ernest Hemingway, and Albert Einstein, amongst many, many more, made him one of the most famous portrait photographers of the 20th century. After fleeing Armenia when he was 15 with his family, he ended up in the Canadian capital of Ottawa, where he perfected his art for portrait photography. Ottawa also granted him access to prominent national and international figures, just as World War II was beginning. He worked mostly in black and white with a large 8x10 view camera, often catching his subjects in surprisingly intimate or pensive moments. One of his most famous portraits, known worldwide, even if you don't know who Karsh is, was taken in 1941. It's a portrait of a glowering Winston Churchill. Whilst Winston was posing for Karsh, Karsh decided to snatch the famous cigar from between the Prime Minister's lips. This split second created the bulldog stance, which thereafter became famous as a Winston Churchill trademark. Images like this were printed in Life magazine. This gave Karsh a wider exposure and helped secure his worldwide fame as a portrait photographer. When I look at the Ernest Hemingway picture, Karsh's words ring true in my mind. I find a man of peculiar gentleness, the shyest man I ever photographed, a man cruelly battered by life, but seemingly invincible. I absolutely see all these qualities in this image. Karsh looks invincible, he's upright, the pursed lips, very strong face, so much character. Also, I see the great shyness. He's not directly looking at the camera, he's thinking, he's looking away from it. As the old saying goes, the million-mile stare. His eyes are gentle, but also when you look into them, you can see that he's been around the block a few times, he's really experienced life. He does look battered. He looks weathered. He looks at it in a great way. Capturing all these emotions on one frame, one negative, to me that's capturing the subject and creating the best of portrait photography.